Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicher, a retired lecturer in mythology, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, and Nanak was the second coming of Jesus. Here I'm doing Gospel of John, verse 48 to 59, which is very interesting. And John the Gospel, as you know, is a very high standard. And greater than this is that of Philip, Gnostic Gospel of Philip, Thomas. They are much better, because these Gospels, they have been corrupted by the Messianic Jews. They have introduced their own terms. Even the translation of the Gnostic Gospel, they have introduced them. Never mind. By the Holy Spirit, which is the discerning intellect, you can find the corruption easily. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. They are the same. Delivered by Jesus, the first anointed Christ of the Most High Living God, Elohim, that dwells within us. Because this is the temple of God. God lives in us if it's clean. If it's got, it has got the blood money, which we call greed blood. Blood, when you are greedy, then you are sucking the blood of somebody. So that's called greed blood. Then Satan lives in your heart, not God. God needs a heart which is truthful. That's why Peter killed two liars, Ananias and Sapphira, for telling lies. No liars allowed. Heart which is truthful and no hypocrisy. What is inside is outside, like little children. So that's why Jesus, unless you become a little children, you can't enter the royal kingdom of God. So it's up to you to clear your heart, to let the God enter. And once the God is entering your heart, He will guide you everything, as He is guiding me and guided Jesus, apostles. So that is called within us, called Emmanuel. He was the first anointed light from our Father, and Satguru. Satguru stands for two words. Sat means absolute truth. Guru means the preacher, so which is same thing as Christ, Nanak, the second anointed, greatest of all the Christ, because he had to confront the kings and emperors of darkness, kings of the Khatris of the Amritsar and Lahore, emperors are the Khatris of Kashmir. Kashmir is the epicenter of the sons of Satan. All these mullahs, they mostly come from Kashmir, and they are the troublemakers. The emperors of darkness are Khatri tribal people against the people of Judah tribe, the princes of darkness that Jesus confronted in the Judea region. He came in 1469 and preached gospel to perfection through five more lives for 150 years. Still, the darkness could not be comprehended. Then our Father himself came in the name of Royal King, which is Sache Pasha in Punjabi, Govind Rai Ji, with his consort, Shakti, Holy Spirit. You know Holy Spirit, our mother? In the Bible, same. In the name of Mahadevan, to sort out the stubborn sons of Satan with sword power. Sons have no authority to take the life, but our Father and his philanthropic soldiers, Khalsas, the Puritans, do have. Remember Cromwell, Oliver Cromwell. He sorted up the British affair. In India, we had a lot of trouble. So we had to organize a community. So, Gospel of John 8, verse 48 to 59. God's faithful word of love. Introduction, you know, you say, John 8:48. In yesterday's reading, that's what they, I get a message from American Bible Society. So every day I do the exposition. In yesterday's reading, Jesus' opponents claimed Abraham as their father. Today's reading continues the debate over their claim as children of Abraham, and Jesus claimed that God is his father. In the ensuing confrontation about this matter, this is the abstract, you know, they are given of the parable, or what we are going to read. The religious leaders accuse Jesus of having a demon in him. I'm telling you the truth, Jesus replied. Before Abraham was born, I am. Now there is something in the other gospel you have read, you know, Jesus, there were Pharisees and Sadducees sitting in the temple. And Jesus wanted to test them whether they know Messiah. So he asked them, whose son is Messiah? They replied, David, which is wrong. David is concerned with flesh. And Messiah is the son of our supernatural father, which has no flesh, spirit. So they were wrong, you know. They could not tell whose son is Messiah. That's why Jesus told his laborers, don't tell these people, blind guide, that I am the Messiah. The Samaritan woman, she was a person of light, spirit. And when she told Jesus that you are a prophet, and when Christ come, he will tell us everything, then Jesus knew that she knew the value of Christ. So with pleasure he told her, I am the one. Otherwise he never told anyone that he is the Christ. And what the people call her? That she had five husbands, one after the other. She was a bad woman, prostitute. In Oxford University, there was a New Testament professor. And I asked him the same question. He said, oh, she was a bad woman. She went to the well alone at the midday, so nobody will see the story, you know, which they have bloody propagated. Shame on you. And I gave him this leaflet, you know, I told him, here are the names of the five husbands. But he never came back to me, because they are super donkeys carrying holy books, and they have no Holy Spirit. So she was a pious, she was St.Photina. And her story, if you put St.Photina, comma, Niger, my name, you will get her story, how she was killed by Nero for preaching gospel, and his son also, you know, they were all preachers. Now, Jesus and Abraham, here is the gospel, you know, verse 48, they asked Jesus, the Pharisee Sadducee and the temple blind guides and the blind, their disciples, were we not right in saying that you are a Samaritan and have a demon in you? Now, Jesus had earlier said, you know, your forefathers are super bastard fanatic devils. And they were very annoyed, because Samaritan could say a similar thing to them. You know, they used to rebuke them. And only the stupid Samaritan will be caught in their web. All the wise were away from them. They were twice born. So, you know, here they say, are you a Samaritan? Now, Samaritans, you know, are the generation of Joseph. They remain faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. So their crops, you know, in the field, you know, because Yahweh is the one who brings rain. If you are faithful to Yahweh, pleasing to Yahweh, he will give you plenty to eat. He will make your land Garden of Eden. So that is what it was, the Samaritan land. The Jewish land was not. Garden of Eden. So they won't let their children go through that one in case they get tempted. You know, hey, what type of people they are, generous, you know. They don't ask for money. They feed you free. The money doesn't matter to them. Money is secondary. Main thing, good eating, good talk. So they will entertain the strangers. I lived in Ghana 14 years. And over there they had a custom that if a stranger come and he is allowed to pick food from your field, cook it, eat it, and go. And if the owner of the field come, he will entertain him with beer also. That means he give him a good treat so that he remembers, you know, that he had a good friend there. And over there, they used to have a custom. I went there in 1969. At that time, you know, the money was not a problem. The devaluation and other things bring problem. So at that time, you know, if somebody eating food, he will invite everybody, come join me. And they will all share. And so will be this, all get together and share and eat. And they were real, like the communist or the Samaritans. So crops and characteristics were far better than the 11 other crook Jews. Outwardly, unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh. Remember, the Jacob had 12 sons. Joseph was the only faithful son to Abraham and to Yahweh. So he had the blessing, spiritual blessing. And when he left the promised land, there was none left who was faithful to Abraham. So the same land became totally barren because Abraham and Yahweh kicked them out of the promised land. Because Abraham is only the father of the faithful, not of the unfaithful people. So he threw them out. And that's why these Jews were thrown out in 70 AD, and now they are getting bundled up for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. They are the tares. They are not wheat plants. Wheat plants are the Samaritan people. They carry the characteristics of Abraham and of Yahweh. So these outwardly unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, you know, 11 other crook brothers, they were accusing him. They needed baptism of John the Baptist and not the Samaritans. Remember, James and John went to the village of Samaritans when Jesus was coming to Jerusalem, and they wanted to baptize because they went ahead in pairs. 70 outer circle laborers went in pair ahead of Jesus, baptizing the people in the name of Abraham. For Jesus, that is called the paving the way, so Jesus can come and preach gospel to the sons of Abraham, or those who are Jews outwardly, super bastard fanatic devils. They were brood of vipers, and they were not given the gospel. So when James and John went to the village, Samaritan village, they said, hey, we are already faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. We don't need your baptism. Go away. So that's why they were angry, you know, that coming back to Jesus, put that village on fire as Elijah did. Elijah is the God of nature, a prophet of the, you know, the creator of nature. Yahweh, he works for Yahweh. They were jealous of the Samaritans, but hated them because they were not greedy and rich like them. They were rich, you know, and poor in that one. That's why Lazarus, poor man, sitting at the door of a rich man who has sucked his blood. And that made him rich, you know. And the Lazarus was so poor, the dogs will come and lick his wound. But rich man had no care for him, that he is the son of Abraham, and I should look after him. I have no demon, Jesus answered. I honor my Father, Yahweh, my Heavenly Father. YahShiva, that's what his name is. YahShiva is made of two words, Yah from Yahweh, and Shiva means Adam, the firstborn of Yahweh, second Adam. But you dishonor me because they were not faithful to Abraham or Yahweh, but a brood of vipers. Remember, John the Baptist said to the temple priests, because they were making Jew outwardly, super bastards. So he tell them, you are a brood of vipers. That is why they killed, die in Holocaust in millions. And that's what we say, kood, dobe pood. Kood means sugar-coated falsehood. They kill people in millions. So the brood of vipers, the super bastard fanatic devils. I am not seeking honor for myself, Jesus said, but there is one who is seeking it, Moses, and who judges in my favor. You know, the Moses is the one who was, you know, made them to repent in wilderness, giving them manna, dry food, so that they repented, they won't be unfaithful to Abraham anymore. That's why he made them faithful to Abraham and to Yahweh, and he stayed behind so they can see the miracle of faithfulness to Abraham and to Yahweh. The same land which was left, they left as barren, had become lush green, Garden of Eden. I am telling you the truth. Whoever obeys my preaching and not teaching. Teaching is the scripture or the moral laws. Jesus was not a moral teacher. He was a preacher of gospel. The dead letters are the scripture are the dead letters. Teaching are the dead letters will never die. Because the living gospel is for the living in spirit. That is the living gospel that rests in your heart, living heart, is of the living Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our supernatural Father, who dwells in his temple, made not by human hands, but by nature, and makes you eternal, like himself. Because the Son, that is why, you know, when Jesus said, I am the Son of the Most High, then the Jews said, he is making himself equal to God, because the Son represents God. He is not equal to God, but Son represents God at the same level. He is the ambassador, omni, we can call omnipotent, or omnipotent, what we can, having all the powers. Is that the right word, omnipotent? He is the omnipotent ambassador of our Father. So what the Father can do, he can do. They said to him, now we know for sure that you have a demon. No, a demon, you know, as the people call Gnostics, the heretics. I live in Reading, you know, and over there I went to a couple of churches. In one church I went, and there was a Carey Baptist Church. Carey went to India, Bengal, and over here preached gospel. I was called a heretic by Carey Baptist Church hireling priest in Reading for explaining to him the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman at well. So I said, okay, let me explain to them. I went to his house and explained to him these are their names. He could not understand because the gospel come to those who are predestined of our Father. So he just listened to me, and when he went to the church, you know, and I was there, the passage came, you can't serve Mammon and God. I was just sitting laughing, you know, let's see what he say. He is working for Mammon, you know what he would say. Then his open words, he said, among you is sitting a man who gives his own literature. I give my own, you know, leaflet like this, you know, to people. And don't take anything from him unless it has the stamp of the church. And this man is a heretic. And they knew who he is. They knew me, but nobody said to me, hey, why they call you heretic? It's not right. They were all sitting quietly and dead because they were spiritually dead people. Very hardly you find any, especially British people are a nation of shopkeepers. Shopkeeper doesn't want to offend anyone. So I went to one of the church and there was a plaque in the church. The fallen soldier died to glorify God. I took one of the church elder purposely, you know, I asked him, can you please explain me how you glorify God? He said, if I were the right, you know, it is wrong. I would tear them down. But he was part of them. He followed the wide road that led to hell. You have to find narrow gate. Narrow gate you find only when you become solitary. But that man knew it is wrong, but he won't be solitary. Because a nation of shopkeepers, they dare not preach gospel. They are frightened, you know. So at Wells, there are many people who knew this subject, but they won't open their mouth. So the woman at Samaritan woman at Wells, St.Photina, another Church of England priest, stood up. You know, I went to nearby church, St. John's Church. He was the PhD in mathematics or physics, you know. And I thought he is educated, you know, let me explain to him. I went there and we sat down outside his house and I explained to him the five husbands. And all of a sudden he stood up. I, being ordained by the Church of England as the priest, I proclaim you a heretic. I laughed, you know. So such are the people, you know. And he stood up and claimed me a heretic. Abraham died and the prophets died. Now these people who are once born, you know, only they know the things of men, not of God. So that's why, you know, blind guy leading me blind into the pit. So the once born people, you know, said Abraham died and the once born people born and died and the prophets died, Moses and John the Baptist, Elijah. Yet you say that whoever obeys your teaching will never die. They being once born, they only knew teaching, not preaching. Preaching is known to the twice born people. Men of letters know only the teaching of books, scriptures, and not the preaching of living gospel from the heart. Gospel comes fresh. Nobody can write it down in ink on paper. It comes fresh from your heart. Gospel is new, brand new cloth, untouched by human hand. Only the individual receives it who does the logical reasoning. Only he gets the gospel in his heart. Other people will hear. They will say, what type of strange teaching it is. They will call it a teaching. They won't take it. That's why Jesus, you know, when we are preaching gospel, many people left it because they found it strange. They want a proof where it is written, but gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablets of hearts of the twice born, predestined people capable of logical reasoning. If you can think logically, you get it. If you can't think logically, you will not get it. Our father Abraham died. You do not claim to be greater than Abraham, do you? And the prophets also died. What do you think you are? They were questioning him. You know, once more people, as they will ask me also, you know, same question. Prophets are angels. Why saints are the very sons of sons of Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah Parbrahm. You know, the angels, they are subject to law, because those people who are perfect in the moral laws, they are called angels. So angels being subject to the law, they are subject to sin as well. But the saints are not subject to the law, but to the Holy Spirit. So saints are only subject to blasphemy, if they say so. But saints, when they think logically, blasphemy doesn't come near. It's only when you clever people, when they think illogically, as the temple priests were doing, and they were feeding sugar-coated sermons of blasphemy, which the once-born people can't understand. Like in India, you know, the Khalistan and this and that, this Mohammedan or Islamic State and this and that. Islamic State, religious state, is a is not a holy, is a Satan, is the state of Satan, because you can't, spiritual self cannot occupy the secular property. Secular property is for the secular tribal people. Afghanistan belonged to Afghan tribe, Balochistan to the Baloch tribe, not to Muslim. If they say it belongs to Muslim, then it becomes state of Satan. And that's why they are killing each other day and night. If it belongs to the people of Afghan tribe, then there can be peace, because they are sons of man, no more sons of Satan. They become sons of Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa Satan, the very high Satan, which this President Morsi, Muslim Brotherhood, he was creating. He was creating the most dangerous fanatic. And I'm glad that the Egyptian nipped him down. In Egypt, the son Adam was worshipped. That's why this Kaaba is the temple of Adam. Is situated there. And when Jesus went to Egypt for protection, you know, for the safety of in the hand of Ishmael, who was faithful to Abraham and Isaac. Sorry, faithful to Abraham. So under his safety, you know, Jesus was sent. The people of Isaac, they had become crook, staunch enemy of Jesus. So that's why he was told to go to Egypt in the safety of Ishmael, the elder son of Abraham. Remember the prodigal son? The elder son is Abraham of Ishmael, Egyptian. They had food. They never met famine. Whereas the sons of the Isaac became unfaithful to him when the Joseph left the promised land. And the promised land became totally barren, and they were thrown out by Abraham. And because they were unfaithful to Abraham, the same is happening in the refugees. The refugees are being thrown out from their tribal homes, where they become Muslim of physical self. Muslim is spiritual self of heart, not of physical self. But these mullahs, which are the sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, they are making them fanatic. And the tribal fathers, they are kicking them out from their houses. And that's why they are becoming refugees in the Europe. Wherever they go, because they are saltless people, they will create problems. And that's why they have problems there. And Germany is sending them back, and so and so. We are in a very tribulation period. It will start in next year in May, 2018 in May, when Israel is 75 years old. Then you will see how hard will be the tribulations. So Parbrahm, Jesus answered, if I were to honor myself, that honor would be worth nothing. The one who honors me is my supernatural father within me, Emmanuel. That is why he could perform these supernatural works, making the dead people alive and walking on water, stopping the storm, which is all natural, healing the sick, everything. That is the work of supernatural. That's what Nicodemus said, you know, unless you are from supernatural father, you can't perform such things. Even he knew he was once born. So these devils, they knew it. And they were sons of the Most High Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa. And that's why they were brood of vipers. So honors me in my supernatural father within me, Emmanuel. The very one you say is your God Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. You have never known him, but I know him, because they were unfaithful to their tribal father, tribal father Abraham, and also the creator of Abraham, or the who brought Abraham into promised land, Yahweh. He was unfaithful to Yahweh as well. That is why the land became barren. Yahweh is the one who brings food through rain. If you are faithful to him, you get rain and you get food to eat. If you are unfaithful, you go hungry. You know, protection. That's why in Pakistan, India, we say when somebody is departing, you know, from you, we say Khuda Hafiz. Khuda is the creator of nature. Khuda is same thing as Yahweh or Brahma. Hafiz means protects you. If I were to say that I do not know him, I would be a liar like you, as they, by becoming Jews outwardly, broke their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew. He was of Semitic race, outside his tribal self, not the spiritual self, Jew. Jew is a spiritual self, way of life, like Sikh, Hindu, Muslim, Christian, is a way of life. It's not physical self. If you become Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Christian, Jew outwardly, then you become super bastard fanatic devils, which we call tares, parable of wheat and tares. And they are being getting bundled up in Israel now for the final burning. Matthew 13 verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled now. And next year will be this 70 years of protection. Then afterward, no protection, as said, temple was destroyed in 70 AD, not before. So Israel is protected for 70 years. Then those people who are fake sons of Abraham through circumcision, Iranian, Indian, Pakistani, they are not of Semitic race, they will kill them, because our Stephen warned them not to make fake sons of Abraham, and they killed him. Much more I can tell. Gospel is in my heart. It comes from my heart. That is how it should come from you. But they were still proclaiming the covenant. They were still saying, you know, after becoming unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, they were still saying that we are sons of Abraham. They were liars. The liars, you know, but I do know him, that I know him, you know, so I'm the proper son of my father. I obey his word. Your father, Abraham, rejoiced that he was to see the time of my coming in the order of Melchizedek Sadhu. Remember Sadhu, Melchizedek? This is the royal priesthood is of the same Melchizedek Sadhu, purely spiritual. He was living in the wilderness. And same Jesus and his apostles, they took to wilderness. So royal priests, they are roving, going from one church to the other. But when the Messianic Jew, they bring in their poison scripture, which is the Jewish leaven, old wine into the church and made people drunk with the dead letters of the Bible, as they are doing in the universities now. And I go and when I talk to them, and I find them, they know nothing, you know. I call them super donkeys carrying holy books, and they get very, very annoyed. But they can't say anything to me, because when I ask them, tell me in whose name John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water, and why he did not baptize a woman or a Gentile, they have no answer. They don't know in whose name he was baptizing, never mind why he did not baptize a woman or a Gentile. He saw it and was glad, you know, he was righteous, you know, and Melchizedek Sadhu, Abraham was righteous person. That is what we need in God. Treat others as you wish to be treated, that is to be righteous. They said to him, you are not even 50 years old and you have seen Abraham. That means, as Nicodemus said, you know, how can I be born again? Shall I go back into the womb of my mother? So same way, you know, these people are saying that, oh, you are just 50. How can you say that you have seen Abraham and all those things? And also, but I am telling you the truth. Jesus replied, before Abraham was born, I am his word, the son. You know, the word was in the beginning and word became flesh. From the word, everything was created. Because Abraham, this Yahweh is a potter. He makes this pot, but the pot without soul is dead. So the word, his word, then give life to this pot. Remember Jesus, when he was playing on Sabbath in a pool of water, he fashioned 12 sparrows of clay. And a rabbi passed by, it was Sabbath. Hey, you can't work on Sabbath. You are making pigeons, sparrows. He went to his father, you know, hey, look what your son is doing on Sabbath. Stop him. They both came, you know. And when they both came, Jesus clapped their hand and the 12 sparrow flew away. That is the power of supernatural Father, which the son was carrying. He was the life of the world. I am telling you the truth, Jesus replied, before Abraham was born, I am his word, the son. In the beginning was the word, and through word was made all this, what you see with your two naked eyes. Then they picked up stones to throw at him. But Jesus hid himself and left the temple. Now, one thing you should see, he just proclaimed that he is the Son of the Most High. They knew that if the Son is the representative of the Most High, he is making himself equal to the Most High Elohim. And they told the other people not even to write his name, miss one letter, Yahweh, they can't write it full. They miss one of the letters. They honor Yahweh so much, which is Demiurge, creator of male and female. And that is just Demiurge. The real one is supernatural Elohim. And he was proclaiming to be son of the Elohim. Supernatural, how annoyed they would be, you know, that Jesus is proclaiming to be son. That is why they were so annoyed that they wanted to kill him for proclaiming himself to be the son of the Most High. That is why when they enter the fold of Muhammad, then slowly they introduce their temple practices. And you can see how annoyed they were at Jesus proclaiming to the Son equal to of the Most High. These Jews, when they enter the fold of Hazrat Mohammed Sahib, introduce circumcision, making them the fake sons of Isaac. the super bastard fanatic devils. Kosher, which is same as halal, and the Allah, and that Allah is spirit, and he has no wife and no son. They know only, that is why Allah is sun, you know, but their mosque, you will see them, moon and star. Moon and star is the witness to the light, and not the light. John the Baptist is moon. Moses is moon. Prophets are moon. Saint come from sun. Sons of the Most High. So, they're, you know, they're disciples of the rabbis, Farsi, Sadducee, moon. They only know Creator. The Elohim is told only to people who are sensible. Samaritan people told the Samaritan rabbi, he used to tell the sensible people of Holy Spirit things of our supernatural Father Elohim. That is what the Samaritan woman at the well, she knew Elohim. And that is why she wetted Jesus in spirit. And in spirit she proclaimed that you are a prophet. She said, when Christ come, he will tell us everything. So Jesus was so pleased with her knowledge that he said, I am the one. So she was so happy. She went to her village, and the village people, whole village, came out to greet him. Jesus told her, look, white crop, ready for harvest. White crop in white-hearted people. Their rabbi had created them. Somebody sowed, somebody else came to harvest it. Christ Jesus went there to harvest the crop. So many things I can tell. No customer. So please preach gospel and let us spread it, because the end of the world is coming. You will soon see the tribulation. Jesus had 4 years of preaching gospel. We will have 5 years, and we have televisions and broadcasting and all that. And Jesus said gospel will be preached before the end of the world, which is expected on 14th of May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. Our Father Allah Elohim Parbrahm, he knows better than I. Our Father blesses you.